to look at two aspects that are important to the care of home care clients. One is their level of frailty. So frailty is a geriatric syndrome, and it's a way to place an older client on a continuum of health. So there are those that are relatively not frail, or what we call robust, and then they're all the way up to those who might be more frail or very frail. And frailty, of course, is related to the help that's required to help support them in the home so that they can perform activities of daily living, get help with instrumental activities of daily living, and to do well with a high level of quality of life. The other aspect that we looked at was caregiver distress, which is also important because the more frail an older client is, the more likely that their caregiver helping in the home might have some kind of distress. This is particularly the case if the caregiver is a spouse who is also older and experiencing their own health issues, but also for a child or a child-in-law who might have unique challenges with caring for their own children, their own health, and then also the health of the parent. So we were interested in the dynamic interplay between the level of vulnerability or frailty in a client and the level of distress in their caregiver in predicting important outcomes, and that would be things like placement in a nursing home, hospitalization, mortality. We used linked clinical and administrative health data available to us through ICES, and we had information for seniors, about 250,000 of seniors who were assessed for home care between 2010 and 2013. With that assessment, it's a very rich clinical assessment tool, we were able to derive a measure of frailty, and so then we could classify home care clients based on how frail they were. So they might be not very frail, somewhat frail, and have more higher level or more severe frailty. And then on the assessment is also a measure of how distressed their primary caregiver is, whether it's a spouse or a child-in-law. So we can sort the data in terms of their level of frailty and the presence or absence of distress in their caregiver, and then try to understand how both those factors influence outcomes over the one-year follow-up. In terms of findings, we observed that 1 in 5 older home care clients in Ontario showed frailty, and even though there were significant differences between male and female clients in their health and their social circumstance, they showed the same prevalence, so 1 in 5. However, even though the prevalence was similar in terms of frailty, male clients who were frail were much more likely to have a distressed caregiver. So about 50% of male clients who were frail had a distressed caregiver, compared to about 40% for frail female home care clients. Not surprisingly, the level of frailty, so the more frail someone was, the higher the risk for all health outcomes that we looked at, in particular nursing home placement and death. And the risks associated with frailty were higher for women than men. We also found that having a distressed caregiver was an important predictor on its own of two key outcomes, the likelihood of going into a nursing home and also the likelihood for a prolonged hospital stay, and that was true for both male and female clients. Interestingly, we found that caregiver distress was a very important predictor of nursing home admission, even if the client was not frail, which is a key finding. In terms of implications, we are across Canada seeing a tremendous shift with healthcare reforms from institutional to community-based settings. And as we witness that, we're worried about the potential stress on caregivers and supports that they might need as well as home care clients. So as we see that shift and the increase in complexity and frailty level among home care clients, we anticipate that caregiver distress will only increase in the future. So it's very important to understand the role that caregiver distress plays over and above knowing the vulnerability or frailty status of a client in predicting important outcomes, so that we can better plan and anticipate healthcare needs, support needs, and to get those services in at an earlier stage and hopefully avoid adverse outcomes.